वेलकम व्यूअर्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 31. दिस इज एक्सरसाइज 18 ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10 एमएल अग्रवाल. वी नीड टू प्रूव, ऑलरेडी वी हैव प्रूव्ड ऑल द क्वेश्चंस. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन. सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 31. इफ साइन थीटा इज प्लस कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू रूट टू साइन 90 माइनस थीटा, 90 डिग्री माइनस थीटा, शो दैट कॉट थीटा इज इक्वल्स टू रूट टू प्लस वन. इट मीन्स दिस इज गिवन and we need to prove it. So let's start. Given that sine theta plus cos theta is equal to root 2 sine 90 degree minus theta. Okay, so I just copied these two things and this one also, and then sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta, so I have written here and mentioned here also. Now I have transferred this cos theta this side in LHS, so this cos theta will divide whole things, whatever is here in LHS. So sin theta by cos theta and cos theta by cos theta is equals to root 2. Okay. So sin theta by cos theta means 10 theta, okay? Plus cos theta cancelled. So plus 1 is equals to root 2. Then I transferred 1 from here to RHS. So, and we can write 10 theta as 1 by cot theta because we have to reach up to 10 theta and cot theta. That's why I've changed this 10 theta into 1 by cot theta and this 1 transferred there. So it is root 2 minus 1. Now what I did, I just written the reciprocal. Instead of writing 1 by cot theta, I have written cot theta, and there root 2 minus 1 was there, so I have written 1 by root 2 minus 1. Okay, reciprocal. Or you may understand by cross multiplication. Cot theta is here and root 2 minus 1 is here. In both the way you may understand. And then what I am doing, now I have to solve it. So by rationalization, I have rationalized it. Denominator, so I have written 1 by root 2 minus 1 into root 2 plus 1 upon root 2 plus 1. This is also plus 1. Now what, 1 into root 2 plus 1, here is root 2 minus 1 into root 2 plus 1, that is a minus b, a plus b. So a square minus b square means root 2 square minus 1 square. So I did it. See, I have written here that cot theta is equals to root 2 plus 1 and root 2 square minus 1 square. Just copied the previous page line so that you can see what I have done. A square minus b square, okay. Now, cot theta root 2 plus 1 and root 2 square means what? Root 2 into root 2, that is 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. So, cot theta is equal to root 2 plus 1. Proved. Now, see question number 32. If 7 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta is equals to prove, where theta is greater than equal to 0 degree and less than equals to 90 degree, then find the value of theta. So I've started solving the sum. 7 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta is equals to 4. I have written that we know that sin square theta is equals to 1 minus cos square theta. So in place of this, I'm going to write this. So 7 into 1 minus cos square theta, I have replaced this plus copied as it is rest things. Now I open the bracket. This is 7 into 1, 7 minus 7 cos square theta plus 3 cos square theta is equals to 4. So 7 minus, see both the terms are same, like terms, we can't say same terms, we have to say both are like terms. Here is minus 7 cos square theta and this is plus 3 cos square theta, so this is minus 4 cos square theta and there was 4. Now what? Now I have transferred this 4 this side and minus 4 cos square theta in RHS. So here is 7 minus 4 and this will be there, 4 cos square theta. Now 7 minus 4 is 3, that is equals to 4 cos square theta. Now what? Again read, I have written the same thing, this number in LHS and that number in RHS. Now transfer this 4 that side. So cos square theta is equals to 3 by 4. So cos theta means what, square became square root. So it is root 3 by 2. Then I have written that cos theta is equals to root 3 by 2. And this is value of cos 30 degree. It means theta is equals to 30 degree. That is our answer. Done. Now question number 33. If sec theta plus tan theta is equals to m and sec theta minus tan theta is equals to n, then prove that m into n is equals to 1. So I've started from here only. I've written LHS is MN, so we will multiply the value of M and N. M is sec theta plus tan theta. So I've written here, and N was sec theta minus tan theta. And you can see this is A plus B, A minus B formula. So I've written A square minus B square, that is sec square theta minus tan square theta. Instead of writing sec square theta, I've written 1 by cos square theta minus sine square theta by cos square theta. Then we are going to solve it. We have taken LCM from both the places, that is cos square theta. So here is 1 minus sine square theta. And we know that 1 minus sine square theta is also cos square theta. We have mentioned all the entities whatever we have used. Both cos square theta cancelled, and therefore that is equals to 1. That is RHS proved. See question number 34. If x is equals to a sec theta plus b tan theta and y is equals to a tan theta plus b sec theta, then prove that x square minus y square is equals to a square minus b square. What we'll do, let's see. From proving point, from here we will start. From LHS, x square minus y square, we'll put the value of x and y. So I did that. Instead of x square, I have written a sec theta plus b tan theta square minus, instead of y, I have written a tan theta plus b sec theta, which is given, square. Then I have opened the bracket as a plus b whole square, and here also a plus b whole square. So first term square, second term square, plus 2 first term, second term. A sec theta into b tan theta, I have written 2ab sec theta tan theta. Minus sign is here, and then inside the bracket, first term square plus second term square plus 2 first term second term. Okay, now we are going to open the bracket. Because of this minus sign, all the terms whichever are inside the bracket, they will change as negative numbers. So a square sec square theta, b square tan square theta, plus 2ab sec theta in 2ab sec theta into tan theta, then minus a square tan square theta, minus b square sec square theta, minus 2ab tan theta sec theta. Now when we'll see that these both terms are like term, but with opposite sign. This one is with plus, this is with minus, so both are cancelled. And a square sec square theta, I have copied. B square tan square theta, copied. And minus a square tan square theta and minus b square sec square theta. These are the four terms remain. Then what I did, I saw that this is sec square theta. This one is also sec square theta. But here a square is multiple of sec square theta, multiplied with sec square theta, and b square is multiplied with sec square theta. So we assembled these two terms at first, and at last rest two. So from these two, I have taken sec square theta as common. So what is the remaining thing? A square, and here is minus b square. Sec square theta is outside the bracket, and here is a square minus b square. So from these two bracket, what I want a square with plus sign and b square with minus sign. So I have taken minus as common. Okay, are you listening me, children, what I said? Because here is a square minus b square, but here a is with minus sign and b is with plus sign. So I have taken minus so that both the term will look similar. So minus is outside the bracket, and tan square theta is in both the brackets. So tan square theta is also out of bracket. So here is minus b square and plus a square. And in next line, just I have rearranged the number. A square minus b square, tan square theta, minus sign, a square minus b square, sec square theta. Now from both the groups, we can see that we can take a square minus b square common. So I have taken a square minus b square, and here is sec square theta, and here is minus tan square theta, and this is equals to 1. So that is proved. That is equals to a square minus b square, RHS proved. You just see here, a square minus b square into 1 is equals to a square minus b square minus b square, that is equals to RHS proved. Now last question of exercise 18. If x is equals to h plus a cos theta and y is equals to k plus a sin theta, prove that x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equals to a square. Now I was thinking value of x is given and y is given, but we need value of x minus h. So what I did, I have transferred h here for this I have transferred k here. Then what happens, see, since x is equal to h plus a cos theta, therefore it is x minus h is equal to a cos theta. I have written equation 1. Similarly, y is equal to k plus a sin theta, therefore y minus k, k transferred here, is equal to a sin theta. Now I am having these two values from here. I have written equation 1 and 2, and I have written that we need to prove that this plus this equals to a square. LHS is x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square. Putting value of x minus h and y minus k from equation 1 and 2 in above equation. So what is the value of x minus h? A cos theta. So I have written a square cos square theta. Okay. And what is the value of y minus k? That is a sin theta. Okay. You may write first of all this one, that a cos theta square, and here a sin theta square. So in next line it is a square cos square theta, and here is a square sin square theta. So from both the numbers I can take a square as common factor outside the bracket. So inside it is cos square theta plus sin square theta, and we know that cos square theta plus sin square theta is equals to 1. So a square into 1 is a square, and that is equals to RHS proved. So children, here our exercise is over. I left few sums which is easy to solve. If you found that or you face any difficulty to solving those sums, please write in my comment section or in my inbox. Subscribe my channel. You must like my videos and try to share it. And write in my inbox if you want more solution of any other question which I haven't solved, because you need to do practice on your own also. That's why I leave few sums. But if you are not able to solve or if you are not able to understand, so you may ask me. So very soon I am coming with a new chapter. It may be share and dividends. Till then, bye bye children.